When Battlestar Galactica debuted in 1978, I was absolutely blown away by the show. I love Star Wars, and so I guess it just makes sense that I loved Battlestar Galactica equally. It had it all: a great story, wonderful special effects, nasty Cylons, and a really talented cast, which included the very beautiful Laurette Spang. More on her in just a moment.
But first, let me introduce myself. Hi folks, my name is Dave Sundstrom, and I like to think of myself as something of a pop culture historian, especially when it comes to music, movies, and television. Simply put, I love talking about this stuff. So with that said, let's get rolling.
On Battlestar Galactica, Laurette was Cassiopeia. At first, she was a socialiter, something of a high-class call girl, if I understand my Battlestar Galactica lore correctly. While it was a profession that had the blessing of the elders, as the show progressed, her role changed. After receiving care for an injury of her own, Cassiopeia decided to become a med tech, and her prior life choices were left behind. To say that Laurette was a beauty on the show is a bit of an understatement, but putting her looks aside, she was a great actress, and because of that, her screen opportunities on Battlestar Galactica flourished, and her character expanded and grew over the season. Here she is looking particularly badass with Lieutenant Sheba. You know, leather is not only functional when you're fighting to save humanity, but also very becoming as well. It's sad that Battlestar Galactica only had one season. And I'm sorry, I'm not counting Galactica 1980 as Season 2, because I would have liked to have seen where Glenn A. Larson and team would have taken all of the characters, not just a couple of them.
I have gone on record as saying that canceling Battlestar Galactica was an incredibly poor decision by the ABC television network. In fact, I've done an entire video on it. I'll post a link to that one at the end of this video.
Getting back to Laurette, this was not the first time that I had seen her on the small screen. By the time Battlestar Galactica rolled around, she'd already built a pretty decent resume. For me, her most memorable role before Battlestar Galactica was on Happy Days, where Laurette made two appearances, first as Richie Cunningham's girlfriend Arlene Holden, and then, perhaps even more infamously, Laurette was in the three-parter where Fonzie jumped the shark, as did the show. You know, we owe Happy Days a debt of gratitude for creating the episodes that gave birth to the phrase that we now use to describe when a TV show has ran out of ideas and probably should call it a day. Anyway, Laurette was a different character in those episodes. She was now Fonzie's girlfriend, Wendy.
Of course, back in the late 70s, early 80s, who didn't make an appearance on The Love Boat? In this scene, Laurette is acting alongside the late, great Deborah Lee Scott. But she was also on shows like Three's Company and BJ and the Bear, both pictured above. But then in the mid-80s, Laurette just stopped working. She didn't disappear or go away. She did what lots of people do. She chose to raise a family with actor John McCook.
Here are a couple of publicly available photos that show a very happy and still gorgeous Laurette with her husband and one of her three children, Molly. If you're interested in catching up with Laurette, I'd recommend following her on Twitter. It's clear from her tweets and photos there that she's living her best life, and I am truly happy for her.
And here's something that you don't see too darn often in Hollywood. Laurette has been married to her husband for over 40 years at this point. Congratulations to both of them.
By the way, Laurette and John's daughter Molly has been on Tim Allen's Last Man Standing for the past few years, where she took over the role of his daughter Mandy. When the show transitioned from ABC to Fox, for whatever reason, they decided to recast the children on the show, probably because the previous actors were getting a bit too old. Every great once in a while, Laurette attends a convention, but she's not a regular. If you're a fan and you see one of those Comic-Cons or something like that where she's making an appearance, you may want to hit it, because they are few and far between. Alright, one more pick from Happy Days. Now it's your turn. Please share your memories in the comments section below, and while you're at it, I would appreciate it if you clicked on the thumbs up icon and maybe even considered subscribing to the channel. I talk about music, movies, and mostly television from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.